you get a Reese Volcano alert level, and you get a newly Reese Volcano alert level, and you also get a newly Reese Volcano alert level. This is a brief summary of the current volcanic situation in Iceland as a day after the directly adjacent Bárðarbungu volcano was placed at a raised alert level due to the likely movement of magma. Grímsvötn was also placed at a raised alert level of yellow. However, while we know for a fact that magma is refilling the Reykjanes volcano's magma chamber before its likely next eruption in the latter half of this February, and we presume that magma recently moved at Bárðarbungu, the situation at Grímsvötn is quite different. At Grímsvötn, a glacial outburst flood known as the Jökulhlaup was first detected to be ongoing on January 8th, as you can see in this tremor chart, which continued to get stronger and stronger as subsequent days progressed. At Grímsvötn, these floods can occur for three reasons, which I will now list from most likely to least likely. 1. A short-term increase in fumarolacti gassing underneath volcano, causing additional ice to melt and build in volume. 2. A long-term buildup in meltwater underneath the glacier due to normal levels of fumarolacti gassing. Or 3. A volcanic eruption or the lead-up to one. The reason why Jökulhlaups can directly precede volcanic eruptions is that the fairly rapid removal of hundreds of millions of cubic meters of meltwater from its summit area can sometimes cause enough of a drop in pressure on its underlying magma chamber that it can allow magma, which was already close to erupting, to suddenly be able to break through overlying rock and rise to the surface. Because of this fact, and also since a low double-digit percentage of Jökulhlaups are associated with or precede volcanic eruptions at Grímsvötn, its alert level was raised from green to yellow on January 15, 2025. The Jökulhlaup in question is occurring at Grímsvötn's summit cauldron, with up to a quarter of a cubic kilometer of meltwater expected to drain to the south across the next week. This meltwater has already begun to enter the Gígjökull River, creating the potential for flooding of local roads and bridges, with the peak of this flood expected to occur on Saturday or Sunday. The peak flow rate of this Jökulhlaup is expected to reach between 300 and 1,000 cubic meters per second, translating to an event that would overall be rated as only small or medium in size. Such a figure is a far cry from the Jökulhlaups directly preceding or associated with volcanic eruptions in 1934, 1938, 1996, and 2004, which each ranged between maximum flood rates of 4,000 to 50,000 cubic meters per second. While as of the writing of this video, there have been no area or road closures, this fact could quickly change in the upcoming days. In my opinion, I am personally not expecting this Jökulhlaup to signal or trigger a volcanic eruption from Iceland's single most active volcano in historical time. Not only are the vast majority of Jökulhlaups which occur at Grímsvötn unrelated to volcanic eruptions, but its summit cauldron since 2021 has created a Jökulhlaup about once a year almost on schedule, with the last Jökulhlaup occurring there in January 2024. However, volcanoes are unpredictable, and for all we know, Grímsvötn could end up soon erupting even with a lack of an elevated rate of earthquakes. Such a hypothetical eruption could remain completely subglacial or have an explosive eruption plume break through the Vatnajökull ice sheet and rise into the atmosphere. Grímsvötn's last eruption occurred in 2011, and in historical time, its eruptions have occurred between 10 months and 32 years apart, with an overall average of 11 years apart. Grímsvötn isn't currently overdue to erupt per se, but there are some factors that suggest it is more than halfway to producing its next eruption after 14 years of inactivity. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron Greg Poole for supporting this channel.